Okay, it looks like we should be live now. I'm going to go ahead and wait a moment just to confirm that we're coming through loud and clear and that people can hear us. And if you can hear me, please indicate so in the chat box. And that will let me know that you're getting the broadcast. You should see some writing on the screen, some pictures to say Spiritek Specialist Meeting, February 28, 2016. And you should see something that says live. So if people are receiving this transmission, let me know, and then we can go ahead and get started. Okay. Everyone's saying they're hearing great. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to double check to make sure that it's loud and clear. So if on your end it's not broadcasting loud and clear, please let me know now, and then I can go ahead and adjust the sound. Okay, Coral says it's loud and clear. And so we're going to go ahead and get started. Let me just get into the switcher here and go ahead and switch up things. All right. Okay, wow, this is yet another amazing time we're in, and today is going to be no different. Obviously, this is Spiritek Specialist Meeting. I can't say number two necessarily because we've had some before, but I'm saying number two now because I feel like, especially since the recent previous or the previous Spiritek Specialist Meeting, then we're on to somewhat of a new path with the specialist program and how we're going to be having these meetings at least every other Sunday, and then how we're going to get into different things that are not only going to educate you on how to help others, but also how to assist yourself. And then we're also going to give you the information and everything that's needed to do so. So first, let me just take a moment and, decombobulate myself because I had to deal with the technology. There was some kind of little firmware update in order so that the sound gets a little bit better. And I did that. So I started the stream. It didn't start, so I rebooted it. It started, so here we are. So let me go ahead and start off today by saying that today's specialist meeting is actually in two parts. The first part of the meeting today, I'm actually going to be doing a State of the People address. That's basically where I'm going to reveal some things about the overall condition of humanity and also the planetary system in order for everyone to begin to realize exactly why they're involved in this particular part of their life. Meaning, like, why are you even attempting to become a specialist? Why are you even listening to this kind of information? I mean, what's going on with you? So the first part of this is actually about you, and it's about equipping you with what is necessary for you to know about what you're dealing with out here. In every bit of the aspect, this is a depth conversation, and also it requires your maturity. Because I would say anyway, if you're assisting other people in helping their spiritual, mental, and physical condition, then you're already taking a role of maturity because you're actually becoming a foundation for them. So the whole Spiritek program is not something to really play around with. It's actually you're intervening in a person's life in a time in which it's become very critical for them to either get their head on their shoulders and start to really wake up to what's happening not only to them but those around them, or face the consistent consequences of not doing that. Also today, I have several notes about today's conversation, and the runtime should be around, I would say, an hour and a half if you want to know how long this meeting is going to be. And so yeah, so let me go ahead and get started. I also have notes here, and so what I really want to do, because there's quite a bit to be translated in today's conversation, is I want to be sure that I do have these notes and I go by these notes. So if you see me looking at the notes, then that's the reason. And okay, so it looks like everyone is pretty much connected. I wanted to wait, just a little bit. We'll probably take about 2 more minutes. Some of the announcements, well, mainly one main announcement, which is about sub-IDs. Right now, we have been able to confirm that sub-IDs are working. These are, of course, the IDs that you use to identify with a specific product on the site if you're sending this to someone else, or sending information about something specific to someone else, and anyone involved in the specialist program knows what I'm talking about. Just recently, we had an issue brought up that the sub-ID was not actually tracking how many people were clicking it, But we've been able to confirm that if someone does click it and they go through with some kind of purchase or transaction, it is registering it. They are still working on figuring out exactly why it's not clicking and it has registering as a click in your dashboard, and it has something to do with cookies. So we should have that ironed out next week. And again, these are just some announcements that some people have been asking, some things some people have been asking me about, and just some announcements that we can have to cover this last 2 minutes. So I'm going to go ahead and get started, because that sounds like that it looks like everyone or quite a few people are participating. And then obviously this is being recorded. It's recorded by YouTube. So if you miss something or if you have to step out, you can come back and you can rewind it and go back through it and check out what you may have missed. So the first thing is that for everyone that's present now to really understand what we're doing with the Spiritek Specialist Program and Spiritek in general, is we're actually erecting and creating a group of people that are equipped to deal with the world's current situation, and the situation actually that extends across even the physical world. So in effect, we're training specialists to combat a silent war, a war that few people are aware of, and few people are even in the condition to even think about doing something about it. And so this puts you in a very, very special and unique position, because this war in specific, which we're going to discuss today, is actually taking place on a nonstop basis right now, and it's affecting people in real time. You have people right now in real time being assimilated. And so it's very easy then for you to go back to, let's say, the job, or go back to school, or go back to any place, and then find that even the behavior and the activity of those that are around that haven't chose to wake up has even changed since the last time that you've engaged with them, to also becoming more and more reprobate, more and more completely non-creative and very repetitive, and just all out assimilated by any term. And so many of us have of course been witnessing this. Some of us think that, well, maybe, you know, we're looking into it too deep, maybe we've just been waking up. But the fact is that there is something going on right now in the world that has never taken place for thousands and thousands of years, and it's happening so rapidly that it's kind of taken us all aback in even realizing that this is exactly what's going on. Meaning that when you hear some of the stuff that I'm going to mention today, and I'm not even speaking directly to this crowd, but maybe to others that actually tune into the video and they say, oh, this looks like a cool video, let me look at it and see what's going on. Some of the stuff that's going to be mentioned may be unfathomable unless you have a really firm foundation of Gnostic information, meaning the ability to know without being told, and experience. This means you actually went through a part of this yourself, maybe identified it, maybe attempted to identify it, and it couldn't put it all together, et cetera, et cetera. And then now this clicks for you and you're able to put the pieces into place. And so a big part of this is actually about today's conversation is about giving you all the rest of the pieces that need to be put in place for you to come into total realization about what you need to do, not only for yourself, but also others, but also your service. Okay, because I want to also let people know that Spiritek Specialist is not another job. Okay, this is karma-free wealth in every extent. It does have a monetary benefit to it, but the actual real wealth is far beyond any kind of piece of paper, any kind of coin. It goes into not only having the knowledge, but also the remedy to assist yourself and others. So it cannot be seen as an actual job. So the reward for this, because it's of the highest order, assisting your biorhythm, assisting the humanity in its most troubled time, waking up yourself and not being a part of the herd or the hive, all those moves are major moves in a person's overall cosmic and spiritual progress. So that's why this can't be narrowed down to, okay, this is just how we're going to make some money, or anything that anyone has been trying to say that it is. It is actually limitless to the potential of what it can bring about. And as we've talked about before, that wealth is not just within money. In fact, it was never actually considered as a form of money. Wealth was health. That's why they rhyme. Wealth was children, abundance, fruit, water, all those different things equate to wealth. Money is now the channel or the medium that we often use to acquire those things, or we're often demanded to put forth in order to acquire some of those things. Nowadays, health has become synonymous with wealth, wealth of a monetary status, because even just going into Whole Foods for too long is going to put you back, unless you're growing your own food. And to grow your own food, you need to buy a property. And then to buy a property, you need... So this system has put something in place that even to take your child to have your child delivered, unless you just go and have a midwife deliver the child, you're going to have to give her some kind of conversation. Or if you go to the doctor in the hospital, they're going to need some insurance, or they're going to want direct cash. So what they've done to the system is they've tried to make monetary wealth, money, physical money, as the go-between a person's real abundance. And so all you have to do is make the simple calculation, begin to wise up and realize that your current, the energy within your body, your frequency, all these things equate to your abundance. If you're in great health, you're going to have healthy children. You're going to be able to go out, if you were still a farmer, and plant and put the intention in the essence within whatever you're growing. And it's going to grow faster. It's going to reap more abundance because of the love that's been put in it. So all of that is your true wealth. And so the only thing that Spiritek is doing is it's restoring that for you. It's giving you a good reference point of remembering and allowing others to remember where their true power is. Okay? So the other thing is, there's an addendum to that obviously with billions of people in the world that have no clue about what's going on, somehow here you come with really an obscure idea of what your past may be. Like, you know, where do you come from? You know, as they talk about, you know, the consistent question, who am I? Who am I? So as obscure as that information may be, this time and this moment, this space, finds you getting information that gives you all of the clues, the keys, and the pointers to the total realization of that question. And that in itself is something that's very, very special. It's something that should not be overlooked. If you're actually at times struggling with your own motivation and struggling with your own energetic system, you have to often go to self and come into the realization that, hey, at least I do understand this. At least I have experienced this. And that is far lengths beyond what others have been able to achieve. Now, it's not putting them down. Actually, it's putting you in a position to lift them up. So you have to then begin to realize that if you sit down all day like the emo, or you're depressed, or maybe even in fear, but you're one of the only beings that's actually equipped to deal with the situation as it really is. So that should strengthen you. See, because oftentimes we find strength, our strength, in others, meaning that when you see someone, you may not even be a person that engages too much in the reality, but if you see someone being abused in front of you and you know you have the strength to stop that abuse, that may incite you even beyond your own fears or your own your idealism of, hey, I don't want to get involved in any of that kind of stuff. It may incite you beyond that to do something. Okay, so this is how in many cases you can be empowered by a very misfortunate situation, such as what's happening with humanity now, to use the power and ability that you have, that you've been given, to take a situation from just basically having no solution to start becoming the frontline defense and the frontline offense for bringing solutions. So I'm going to take a moment. And looks like we're doing good. You're going to see me glance at this all the time because I got to make sure that we're connected. I may have to put in some new batteries here in a moment, but to this microphone system, but we'll see what happens. Another thing is that I'll let you know right now, especially for the depth level conversation, that anyone that's in fear places themselves in little to any position to be able to assist others. Especially those that are also in fear, because fear is a frequency. So if you come in with fear and you're trying to assist someone that's in fear, you can already see the problem, because the only thing the fear is going to do is resonate. It's going to resonate within the person. It's going to start resonating with you. And then pretty soon your conversation and your application, your energetic field, all that is going to switch into something that's not going to be beneficial to others. So what I want to tell you now is have no fear. Because, you know, many people found that death is a fear for them. When you study the Egyptian Book of the Dead, when you study the Tibetan Book of the Dead, what it often relates to is how death is an ally. From death or the blackness comes everything. And so it is just a transition phase. It is the friend of humanity in a tense of the time where it needs its renewal. And many of us have began to understand how to apply that to our daily life by allowing things that should have died a long time ago to just be put to rest. So that way we can reincarnate, in a sense, a new perfected version of that. Just as a child comes out fresh, new, brand new enzymes, soft skin, the whole nine. You have to also begin to allow certain things about your consciousness, your programming, and the system that you've been enveloped in to die. In order for you to get to your next phase of fresh, new, as it's called, experiences and also expansion. Okay, so death can never be seen, unless it's in the mind of the ignorant, as some kind of enemy or something to fear. And since that generally is the worst thing, when you really do a survey of the whole world and say, well, what are you afraid of the most? People will say, well, death. And so since that's the number one, between number one and number three are the worst things, and we've already eliminated that with just that level of resolve, then you can start depleting your level of fear, which is going to allow also your system to flow freely, because fear is compression. But we'll talk about that here in just a moment. So the next thing is, you can also begin to determine how much you're able to assist another person by how much fear you really have and how much compression you really have. If you can't get out there and say what needs to be said, especially to people, see, this is not all about you going to the front of the courthouse and telling them about, you know, all the legal system and all this kind of stuff. This is about getting in front of people that are your friends or supposedly your friends, getting in front of family members, and actually having the ability to not be in fear of what may happen next if you happen to begin to release these truths to them without fear. Okay, so we have to also realize fear is not always just being scared of this boogeyman or these deformed life forms or, you know, whatever the case is on an external level or something that may scare you. Fear also manifests as any level of compression, meaning something that is holding you back from acting out and living out your true potential. That is what fear is. So if you have that, like you can't act out your full potential because of X, you need to begin to work with X and remove X in order for you to fully come into the potential of what you can do for yourself and others. You see, so this all connects together. Notice several times during this conversation, I'll say yourself and others, because what I'm going to be talking about, I don't want to make exclusive to you, because some people have actually graduated certain parts of what's going on and still find themselves trapped in other parts of what's going on. So it's not a one size fit all. Each person has their own scenario. So what I'm doing is I'm presenting the information for you. I'm not necessarily talking directly to you about everything, because you'll know what resonates with you and what doesn't, but you'll also be able to realize all the entire scope of this, like what others may be facing. And then this blueprint will also give you the key of analyzing today's modern reality. So today what is introduced is a blueprint of how to analyze the so-called modern reality of today. Okay, this is going to give you all the keys. This is going to put some of the big pieces of the puzzle together that you've been missing. So that's why I call it the State of the People address, which I've actually been meaning to have for quite some time, but of getting to a certain forum, which is today and now here in the house, in the makerspace, to be able to point by point explain to people stuff that is going to impact them and has been impacting them for their time of being here on this planet, okay? And so the first thing is, we need to understand how planets actually work. Like, what is a planet? Because, of course, there's now the arguments about what's what size it is, what shape it is, even what color it is. But the fact of the matter is there's nothing that exists that is not projected and manifested in the physicality from our hearts. Meaning that everything that you see around you has been manifested into physicality from the collective heart, okay? The source of things. And so it's important to realize that. So whatever we put in will come out and manifest, whatever size it is, whatever shape it is, etc. So the next thing to remember is that, okay, especially now in this time, what you'll find is each being, which generally is denoted as a spirit in Gnosticism, each spirit, which there's one in you, there's one in the dog, there's one in the beetle, there's one in the plant, each of these spirits are projecting a fraction of the soul, okay? They are basically exhibiting a fraction or an ideal or a characteristic of a soul. Okay, and what a soul is a soul is all of those spirits, all of those different characteristics, all of them in one. Okay, and that's what some may call a group soul, but really it's just one thing. So the soul is the mainframe, if you may. It is the is all and will ever will be. And then the spirits are partial reflections of that. Okay, so this is also why when a person starts to harmonize more, they gain more knowledge and ability. Some people can fly into birds. Some people can hear trees talk. Some people can read into other people's mind. There becomes all these different things that they begin to do as they begin to become more of the soul rather than the individual spirit. So we need to understand that the planetary system, everything that's ever happened, everything that will happen, every frequency that there ever has been and will be, is all encased within one thing that we call the soul. And it can be seen at times as a mainframe because it contains all of the data, all of the information, and everything that is necessary. And let me look at this. Okay, excuse me. I just was hearing some things and I thought maybe we disconnected. Let me turn a couple things off here that are making noises and disturbing things. So remember, so this soul, which is some people call Gaia, is a mainframe that is storing all the data and all the information of everything that you did and everything that you used to do and all of how you felt and all those different things, because it has done all of that before. It has the seed to all of those interactions. So this is also why when you connect to the soul, as many shamans will say that when they get people coming from the Western world, and of course, because they can see the spiritual plane, that's all they really do is work with the spiritual plane. They can see this artificial disconnection that the person has between them and the source, their mother and their father. And the only thing they work to do is restore that connection, because once that connection's restored, then the person starts having this aha moment. Oh, ha, I'm really God, or I'm beyond God. And then so they start to come into this full awareness, because all they're doing is they're tapping back into the soul, which is the source of spiritual life. Okay? So all the spirits will always need the soul, because the spirits, in a sense, are just reflections. Okay, so remember that they're reflections. They're just partial pieces of a mirror, a facet, as they say, a facet or a face. It's just the face or the character, one part of the whole. And what we're encouraged to do is to begin to become and restore our connection with the whole or the source. And the reason is because it's also very, the term is holographic, meaning that there's no part of the hologram that doesn't contain the whole. So what that means is once you connect into the soul, you also connect into the cosmic soul, which also connects into the galactic soul, on and on and on and on. It all just reconnects itself. Okay? So just so you understand how this is set up, because it's important to understand what spirits are and how they operate, and then what the mainframe or the soul force, the planet, Gaia, Sophia, etc., is got going on in its embodiment and its makeup, because then you'll realize why some of the things are happening right now, are taking place, and what exactly those things are designed to do. So the next thing is that Each inhabitant, well, we talked about that. Each inhabitant of the planet exhibits as a part of the whole. And every soul is tied in. Well, hold on real quick. Let me see. Everything is done. Okay, I went through that. I kind of went through all of this in very briefly in just that statement. So this fast forwards us actually to a part of our history to where we were given false promises. Okay? And this is now to let you understand, what cut us off from the soul? Why would we ever want to detach from the soul? And the answer to that question is that there became false promises. And this is also encased actually in the Bible. It's actually encased in many traditions of when a being that is already tapped into knowing everything goes into wanting to know something, which is like oxymoronic. It's like, well, why do you need to listen to something else if you're tapped into everything? Why should you refocus your eye on something else if you're focused on to what sees everything? Okay, so this is key because you are the source. Because when you're focused on yourself, you can see everything. You actually go within, hence the term innerstand, and you begin to actually see and experience things on a quantum level. You are a quantum system. So it's only if you go outside of yourself and then accept something else as being that, then the fall begins. And so you notice then that that's how all religions are designed. That all of a sudden, you're no longer the central processor. You're no longer the key character in the story. It becomes some other being, whether it's Buddha, Brahma, God, you name it. See, the best of these distractive systems are the ones that you would not believe do that. But if there's anything in that system that says, well, this person you should look to. Because remember, what we're talking about and we've been talking about for the last 7 years is empowering you. Sevan is not the central character in the theme. You are. This is all about you. I'm explaining to you, hey, this is what's going on with me, so this is possibly what could be going on with you. Not, hey, worship me. Hey, I know all this knowledge. Come follow me. It has nothing to do with that. So what this shows us is there was a time to where when religion stepped in. See, religion is the technology. Okay, technology is not new. Technology has been in floating through space for billions of years and even beyond time. Technology is a frequency and is an idealism. Okay, and what this idealism says is that something is more powerful, something is more smarter, something is more faster. And if I can adapt to that, then I will be friends with it. You know, that's how people are with God. It's like, well, God's more stronger, God's more powerful. And if I worship God, then God's going to be my friend and then God's going to look out for me. OK, so this is a person who's been clearly removed from their true consciousness that they're connected to everything and that all there will ever be is what is within them. And especially when it comes to realizing it. Meaning that you cannot realize anything externally, only internally can you truly what we call realize something. Just like you can't read any book and then expect to have gone through what would be the experience. You may have run a hypothetical mental drill, but you didn't go through the actual experience. So reading about being a shaman, reading about being a mother or a father is nothing like actually doing it. So we need to make that very clear that the real inception or schism was the advent of a technology known as religion, which removes you from the control point and then places something else in that position. Okay? So this, or anyone who ever wants to know, well, how did this happen? This is how it happens. And now you can see it rampant in the world. Pretty much now, if you tell a person that they're God or that they're the supreme being, they will fight you over words like that, insisting that this character should be Jesus or Muhammad or Allah or somebody else beside them. So you know that this program, this technology of the highest level has already been onto the planet and has begun to incept people. Okay? So the next thing is that so that's what the false promise of the alien race is. It's not just X-Files. It's The false promise that if you go outside of yourself, that you'll find something greater than yourself. This is the same thing that NASA is doing. You know, we go out into space and we're going to find this advanced race. We go to technology and we're going to find eventually this vast technology. So this is all the core of what spirituality is. I'm checking here. Okay, so everything's good over here. So what happens is that this is the same system then. It's just disguised as looking like different things. And this is what you have to know. This is what you have to always be aware of, is something that is just disguised as something different, but in fact is the same thing. If someone is not teaching you that you are the source, then flee from them, because they've already been assimilated. That's what the assimilation is to get you to focus your power and your energy on something beside what's going to benefit and empower you. That's why this is designed to benefit and empower you, get you back online, and then you can assist others. That's what innerstanding is. Look within first, all is self. This is the highest maxim. You fix yourself. And then you can start talking about doing something for others, because everything you do then will be a reflection of how you really are. That's how this works. It's holographic. Okay, so let's keep going. So what happens is that technology, this modern technology, which is somewhat much more like iPhones than it is like quantum deep blue wave mainframes, like, because if you just watch the interaction that people have with their little tech, their cell phones and their little Walkmans and radios, and then you start seeing the interaction within that, you can start seeing the play, because people are attempting to do things with that stuff that they could actually be doing with their spiritual capacity. Now, the world somewhat forces the spirit tech to use both. That's why it contains spirit tech, spiritual and tech. Technical. We can technically analyze the situation that we're dealing with in real time and begin to offer spiritual solutions. So as always, we remain as the bridge to assist people who have already fallen off the deep end of one of these polarities. Because the other big key is that what this simulation has as its core firmware is duality or polarity, because once it can get you into duality, then it can take you from a trinary or a whole being to binary, and we're going to talk about that here in a moment. So how religion operated is it became the gateway of technology that allowed the adherents of it, the ones who believed in it, to become assimilated by other forces that generally were already on binary, already on duality, already polarized, already lost their source, already destroyed their planet. Okay? Because we act like we know so much about what's going on here, but if you even ask a person something simple like all the components of what's in grass, then they can't even really start telling you. If you start asking them the entire process of chlorophyll and photosynthesis, they may get even a little hazy. So really the real details to how worlds work, people are devoid of them. But yet they are installed with an ego that makes them say they know. Oh yeah, I know all that's about. And yeah, I don't think what you're saying. And they seem to know so much, but yet can't even realize the situation that they're in, okay? So understand how this works, this assimilation. It keeps this egoistic, a Godhead state of consciousness, a person infected with that kind of thing, so that they don't realize, hey man, you gotta start from square one and start erasing all that stuff, and then start putting things back in one by one once they've been cleared as being authentic. And you use the blueprint to do that, the as above, so below nature, that if it's the truth, you should find its connection within everything. And thus, that's what's authenticating it, not someone else that supposedly has some degrees or someone else that said that they, you know, that a bunch of people followed, and none of that, but your own blueprint that tells you what truth is. Okay, so the next thing is that, so remember that what this tech does whether it's religion or whether it's computers or whatever, is it promotes the dualistic stance in order to polarize a person so they become either a plus or a negative. Either you're on this side of God or you're one of God's enemies. Now look at how it works in the Bible. You have these people who supposedly are the chosen ones. They're on the side of God. And then so just because they're on that side, that means everyone's on the other side, and they must not fellowship with them. They must destroy them. They must do all these different things. That's the technology. Okay? So look at it. It's there. It's happening today. You go up in somewhere and you don't believe what these people believe, these people will kill you. Despite we're all human beings, we all have the same mother, two arms, two legs, and a head. We are spirits with soul force inside of us attempting to reconnect ourselves back to that. But these technologies divide us and cut us off. It's like the cutting of the umbilical cord. It cuts you off from the source. And it's because the beings that are purporting this, they're cut off. They cannot pull energy from the source. They can't pull energy from the sun, as we talked about last meeting. They cannot pull any high levels of energy. And I'm explaining to you why in just a moment. So what happens, though, is that the duality, again, is the core part of the program, which keeps everything in chaos and confusion, and then allows the energy exchange. Because remember what duality is. We talked about it. It's a zero and a one. It's like pistons. It's the yin and the yang. It allows the continuous movement of back and forth, good and evil, bad and good, black and white. And then these movements through the person's consciousness, through their activities and through what they engage in, they generate energy, but they're often under stress. Because when you develop so much binary and polar type of fields, then you stress your whole system because you never have a neutral. Think about what I'm saying. If there's a forward and a backwards, there needs to be a neutral. If there's a positive and a negative, there needs to be a neutral. If there's a good and a bad, there has to be a harmony. So with a person that has a polarized state of consciousness, they don't see that middle pole. Only thing they're looking for is the next person to argue with, the next concept to throw under the bus, the next thing that you see. So it's constant because they're feeding on it. In order for them to get back to the next side of their pole so that they can keep generating for whatever in behind the scenes has them generating that energy of that specific kind, then they'll do. Okay, and we're going to talk about that here in just a little bit. Let me turn this on. 1 second, everyone. I need this to not auto-sleep, as it calls itself, in order for me to make sure that I can see the screen without, you know, going into turning back around, blah, blah. Okay, so here we go. So, in short, the technology is binary. We're trinary, okay? Trinary means positive, negative, neutral. Birth, sustain, destroy. Okay, we have all those components. So in that case, it's like the original state. Okay, and they always say the original state of man. Okay, but wait a minute. Man is now denoted as the male of the species, and there's a female. So that's not a correct statement. We're talking about the original state, which actually behind this illusion of these bodies, you're still in. You're not just a male, you're not just a female, and you have that floating point. So what this is about is that the original state then was trinary. You are the mother, the father, and the child, and you can sustain yourself. When you're cut off, that's why this Bible begins with this splitting of the genetics, some of the alien theories, and of course, the spiritual systems that, you know, the man was then divided from the woman. This is all part of the programming and embedding of the program, attempting to allow you to buy into this concept that you only have two. You're this female, and you have those two, you have this two poles, okay, versus the three, which allows you to be whole and complete. So we talked about before, two is the blinking cursor. It's like a computer. A computer works on two, binary. It's looking for input. Okay, the blinking cursor says, what do you want me to do next? Type in to me something. I need to figure out something. Something still has to, something's not right. So that's the state that humanity is in now. Versus when you're trinary, there, you already know everything. It's like you see all, you know all. There's no the there's nothing to take things from because you'll be pulling it from yourself. You see what I mean? It's a fully whole system that nourishes itself. There's no scarcity. Okay, so let me keep going with this. So you can find this, if some find that those statements in question, let me show you how English is coded with this. You can define the word bio and find out. Now, in our life, bio means the nature. Bio means what's real, the real world, as in biology. Okay, so when we take this word bio, we have two parts to this word. We have bi, which means two, right? As in goodbye. Bi means two, meaning we're going to part. You're going to go one way, I'm going to go the other. Biological, okay? So the first part of biological means two, but there's something that people often neglect, the O. So if I told you to write out bio as a symbol, you will write two sticks or two lines and a zero, which would give you the actual pattern in the diagram to how whole beings work. They have that, what we call male and female component, or positive and negative component, which we've always dissolved in spirituality, occultism, whatever, as being the same thing. That's why I say as above, so below. So positive and negative actually come out to the same thing, and they even cancel out themselves, okay? But the O, which is similar for a symbolic for when you get outside of the symbolic of the symbolism of the matrix, the O is the womb where everything comes forth from, right? So when you have the male and the female in the womb, you are whole. You don't actually, you can self-generate, self-replicate. You get it? So this is why there's talks of androgyny, where beings were originally androgynous, because they're saying they were biological life forms. They contain both parts. They weren't binary life forms, which are actually synonymous with demons, and we'll get to that here in a moment. So just to understand, we have this biological system. So everything in nature was designed, especially when you get behind what you're looking at, when you get behind just the physical bodies and behind what you see is the tree right now on this low vibration that we're on. What you see is all this stuff is connected into the whole and can keep producing and replicating itself based on its own projections. Like basically the idea of what it believes that it is enough to continue to generate over and over again what it really is. And we're doing that too. That's what's called reincarnation. Our ideas of who we really are allows us to continuously replicate who we are. But if somehow we begin to fall off what we really are and start to believe that we're something less than we are, then we come back or forward, as I always say, as that. Okay, so bear with me here. This is going to start making sense in a moment if you're getting a little bit confused, but I have a feeling that many people are still spot on to what's being mentioned here because you're experiencing it in your life. So just understand that our original state is trinary, but it's also possible through mental and even genetic hacking that some begin to become binary, which is thinking they're just male or female, and they lack the ability to be originators. See, not creators. This is the other thing that we need to realize, that creator is one aspect of things. Originator is something entirely different. Originator means something comes forth from you that has never come forth before, never been seen before. It is unique. Versus a creator is more like replication. It's more like cloning. It has its uses to create another baby that is, you know, part your DNA and part the other DNA. But the unique part, that 1%, 2% or whatever of uniqueness that child is created with, actually changes and develops that being into something that is very, very unique. So that originator side of things, the O, is what's often, or no, not what's often, but what is always missing from any binary life form. A binary life form does not have the ability to originate. And because of that, that's why you see many humans now being harvested for their original ideas, which even in companies, even in inventions, and even in the patent office, where you have beings that are still on trinary and whole have active projectors, meaning they can go to sleep and see the entire thing in their mind's eye. And then they come out with this original invention that has never been seen in the reality anymore. And then some big Merck, Pfizer, Chema, whoever comes and takes the idea and scoops it up and then gives the person maybe a little bit of their fake monetary currency. And then all of a sudden the person's originality has been usurped. And then they use humans to do that. Because they are not original themselves. And I'm not going to paint a huge they picture for you today, but it's important for you to recognize the binary entities in your reality, okay, and how they function. So here we go. So the other thing is that, see, what binary life forms are, just so you understand their history, are they were once like us, meaning that they once had the ability to originate. But in their world, which there are many of them, there are many worlds out there. This is not the only one. That's why they say it's so foolish to believe that the only world that's here is the one that's called Earth. That's just impossible. So on other planetary systems, this same process plays out. These particular beings, which some call the Archons, love to run these kind of drills, the same kind of MEs or program memories over entire planetary systems with always the same result. And that's why, as a time traveler, a positive or a harmonic time traveler, you begin to realize, well, where's all this going? You could start calculating, if you may, what all this is going to end up in being, because some of us have recollection of past worlds that may have gone in this direction of binary technology. Because what happens then is that there's always the destruction of the biosphere, meaning that any time a planetary system that is biological attempts to, which is three, attempts to go to two, something's got to be taken away. Something's got to die. You see what I mean? It's not an increase, it's a decrease. And because of that, the being is downgraded from trinary to binary, okay? And this is important because you're seeing it happen in the world right now. People are not tapped into nature anymore. They're tapped into technology. And then before, they're tapped into their religion. They're not tapped into themselves. They're not tapped into themselves as God and the Supreme, and that they only need to keep strengthening their connection with all there really is in order to experience more. No, they're looking to one book. They're looking to one name or one figure or one system, you see? So this is it's the same thing is what I'm getting across here. So when this same thing starts to happen, it takes a trinary whole complete being and downgrades them to binary. And then what happens then is they go into conflict. Why? Because binary is only conflict. It's only a positive and a negative. There must be an enemy. There must be an opponent in order for it to even survive. In short, it needs a battery. Binary beings need batteries. They need conflicts. Computers need batteries. Okay? So this is where this whole thing comes from about how your power can be stolen from you or how some are eating others' energy. Okay? So let me show you how that all plays out. So when the trinary being who is whole gets downgraded to the binary system, then it becomes the decay of their biosphere. This is just like why when they're building all these factories and all these chips and all these guns and all this technology, right? They're destroying our biosphere with all the dirt and all the pollution and all the frequencies and all that. So remember, play it out for yourself. Wake up, Alice. This is Wonderland. What's happening is that these people, and wondering what's going on, not knowing what's going on, are destroying your world. And they're wondering because they're a blinking cursor, meaning they're binary. They don't know how to originate anything, so they don't know what's really going on because they don't know. You see what I mean? This is the stage that binary is in. Computers, they don't know what's going on. They're only taking input and then reacting. Okay? So there are beings, probably quite more than we even think, that did this to their world. And now when you do that, you must find another world. Once you destroy your world, and I talked about this years ago in regards to one of the tribes that had seemed to, according to my research and experience, destroyed their planet. And then from that, went into trying to take somebody else's planet, destroyed them, meaning raped, pillaged, moved them off their land. Those people then went to somebody else's land. Then it's like a domino effect. And this is what Earth's history has really been about, is one tribe has despoiled itself, destroyed all of its mineralistic systems, its haplogroup, its genome, and then become a predator or a vampire to other whole trinary beings. You see what I mean? So this, this stuff couldn't even make up the best of science fiction to how deep it gets. But when you start searching and checking everything, it all checks back and it all makes sense. And again, it's because of the same process that we're witnessing here. What happens if we end up destroying our bile system? What happens if we're not able to catch this in enough time, and then your children and my children and the children that are living now are continue to be brought up into a system that is assimilating them, and to the point where nature is no longer even considered as being a viable component, and then everyone starts to try to fuel themselves on not only low vibratory energy, but also things that have no mineral systems, aka GMOs. And then you run that out for 10 or 15 years. What are you going to be dealing with? World War Z? I mean, what would you really be dealing with? So play it out already. It already happened somewhere else. This is a circle. There's nothing new. In this particular system, it's not original. We have to get to the original state of consciousness, which is a frequency. It's a way of being. So then what happens is that those beings who destroy what they have that they should have cherished, and they should have guarded and protected. Like today, you have to learn how to cherish, guard, and protect your wholeness, because there are vampires, binary beings, demons, whatever you want to call them. There is no fear, but to identify them and to know them is half of the battle. Running around here attached to others, their power is their invisibility, because they cannot manifest. They can't manifest into physicality. They appear as shadows and ghosts and vapors unless they get enough energy in one spurt, enough photons in one spurt from something to manifest very briefly, and then they fade out again because they're ghosts. That's what they look like, the ghost gods, the eidolons, the archons. They can't come into biological worlds, because the biological world sustains itself on an energetic system that they are not harmonic with. So they need you then to destroy your frequency, not only in your body so they can inhabit you, but also your planet so they can inhabit your planet. Okay, and that's how it is. Now, if you think it's a game, if you think it's a joke, look at what's happening in Turkey and Syria. Look at what's happening in any other places around the world besides mainly the purporters of who's doing this, the United States, Israel, etc., who spend most of their time debasing and dumbing down their citizens to not be aware of what they're doing to the rest of the world in a methodical process to ultimately destroy our planet. And this is what you're waking up to every morning. And many people will just go to sleep. People have been trying to put me to sleep for 7 years now. Seven, you need to calm down. All it is ever, and you signed up to be here. Whoa. Forget the Jedi mind tricks. It doesn't work on huts. The reality is I'm looking at what's going on here, and I'm assessing everything from a logical and spiritual state of consciousness imbalance, and this is what's coming back, and I run it back in again to, hey, make sure this is right, because I don't know. This doesn't look like it's pretty far out there. You put it back in, it comes back again. Whoa, you're bringing me back even more, and it's because it all starts to connect. So then at the end of the day, you will drive yourself crazy in not believing this than actually believing it. This is what I start realizing. Even in my infant stages of understanding the spiritual realms, I started getting to the point where I was like, man, it's going to be more difficult for me to believe that this is not happening based on what I'm experiencing and what I'm seeing and what I'm learning than that it is happening. You see, so it's easier when you understand the truth. Okay, so we're going to keep going with this because there's more to it. I just want you to understand. Now watch this, because oblivion approaches, and what you're here to do is to prevent it. And some people will be like, what are you saying? You mean you're talking about we're here to prevent the destruction of the world? Anyone with the frequency of realizing what's going on and starting to push that back and begin to harmonize it is here for that exact mission. It's not that you're going to be the only one and have been the only one. See, sometimes when we accept certain realities, even titles, like if I say you're the supreme being, somebody's the supreme being, and because they've elevated this supreme being so far beyond themselves, they can't imagine themselves as it. So it's the same thing as if I tell you that you're here to put the world and restore the world back into balance and to take it off its wobble and to save your mother and father from exact retribution, then it may seem, oh, then this is too far off. This is more than I can, than is about me. And it's because you're putting it too high. You're putting it on a pedestal. This is about being on the same level. We see eye-eye with this mission because it involves my life and my death, just like it involves your life and your death and what comes beyond. You see what I mean? So that's why it's like, okay, well, this is about me. When you harmonize with something, you make it integral to you. That's all you're doing. So if this is about you, which it is, you're living here just like me, this means that this is you. This is your responsibility. This is your service. Okay? So going on. So the breakdown of the biosphere, which you need to really understand because we're all connected to the biosphere. The biosphere was what I was talking about was the soul or the mainframe of the planetary system. So when that begins to break down, which it's doing now, then the connection between the spirits, the ones still acting out in their individual characters, and the soul becomes less and less. There becomes this disconnection. Because the biosphere is breaking down. This means it's like the neurological paths in the veins within your body. Once there's a blockage, then there can be no connection. So then there's a loss of empathy and a loss of compassion and all the other abilities that are attached into that. Remember, empathy and compassion actually give the person telekinesis. Empathy and compassion is being able to sense the subtle waveforms and frequencies that exist throughout the entire construct. So when you get cut off or you cut yourself off, then you can't feel that. Okay? So many people have now think that that's the benefit. They think that that's their benefit because they can see someone get their leg blown off and not feel anything. Like, well, you know, it's not my family members. Click. And then on next on news, oh, a tornado comes across Hawaii and a guy gets his head ripped off. Next, Hal Dodge is coming out with a new Viper. What? And then you're just like, boom, boom, and it didn't even register as two different things because there's no empathy, there's no compassion. So this same thing about activating chakras and activating your system is tied all into this because if you don't have the activation, meaning that the circuits connect, let's think about this because people try to make activation so complex and even I've been guilty of that years ago when I understood it as what the New Age people were talking about. Activation is as simple as this. If we have, let's say, this device and one of the wires is missing, we're not going to be able to turn it on. So thus, we're not going to be able to power it up. Thus, it's not going to activate. Okay, it's as simple as that. So if one of your main cords, arteries, chakras, whatever you want to call them, happens to be disconnected, you're not going to activate. And without activation, then you cannot perceive. See, you don't have this perception. Let me check these batteries so I can stop looking behind myself. You don't have the perceptions. And these perceptions are what actually equal all your abilities. Okay, this is looking good. Let me just put this back in my pocket real quick here. So just remember what I'm saying. So that's why when you're in these Reiki and in these different sessions and they say, oh, you got some blockages. You have this blockage in your heart chakra. We're going to try to work with this blockage and remove this blockage. You need to realize what they're saying is that the blockage is keeping the kundalini, the energy, your own personal energy source, from running through that area of the system. And if it doesn't run through that area of the system, then there's no activation. If there's no activation, then there's no telekinesis. There's no full awareness. Now, this is the other thing, though. See, when there's a full awareness, the main thing, this is why they always show superheroes when they activate, what generally accompanies that activation? Pain. Think about it. Look at the Hulk. Look at Wolverine. The activation accompanies pain because now when the being activates themselves, they are now tapped back into the soul. And because the soul is experiencing a war right now, they are attempting to cut us off from our planet. And so that is done in oil spills. That is done in earth, in fracking and destroying the ley lines and the artery systems of the planet. That is done by even the planet's own inhabitants throwing paper and plastic in the ocean and all that. So the planet is not in a great mood. So when you activate and unblock Kundalini, that's why it starts for many people a trauma, Kundalini syndrome, etc., because they can't handle the pain. You see? So this is a depth level stuff. Because some people think, okay, well, I'm going to activate this kundalini, and now I'm going to throw fire from my hands and burn Sith. Because they're so mind controlled and programmed off of what's coming on, going on the TV, that they've lost their idea of what this is even really about. That it's designed that way. This is about that you cannot even activate yourself without going back through a past recollection of the desolation of your biorhythm, your mother, your father, your sister, your brother, your friends, and then on back, because then you start realizing how everyone connects to you, and oh my God. Then you start realizing that, man, you're going to be in tears for a while. Many of us have already been through that phase and have to go through those phases in order to not disconnect ourselves from our mother and thus connect from our source and thus disconnect ourselves from our powers. You see? So think about it. So your powers are connected to your ability to deal with the pain. So here we go. I mean, it was no different in the gym, though, because that's the thing of saying, well, that's deep. But it's no deeper than what we deal with when you go work out. You're going to have to deal with the pain that comes behind the soreness in order for you to have more strength. So where did we go wrong here? Like, where is there something that's being stated that does not reflect itself within every other aspect of our growth in this reality? Okay, and there will, of course, be eventual time to where you reach what I call the pinnacle, the peak. To where it doesn't matter. You can sit there and run all day. I can keep lifting this stuff, man. I'm not even worried. Like, I've reached some zone, as they call it. I'm in a zone, man. I don't even feel the tiredness or nothing. Like, the class over already. So there, of course, is that point. But before then, what happens is, the other thing to also realize within this is that when you convert from trinary to binary, then what's lost is, of course, the origination. Remember, that's the main thing that's lost, is the ability to originate. Because once the ability to originate is lost, then the person cannot be the source. And this is why people are always trying to ask themselves, well, where is God and what really created all this and all this kind of disconnection? That's where that comes from. When the trinary being goes to the binary, they miss the zero. So since that's no longer present or suppressed inside of them, compressed inside of them, that's why I say kundalini is compressed inside of the body. It's down in the base of the spine, okay? It's telling you what happened. That's why I said in the tail of the human being, the spine, is their story. And every time a tail runs off, meaning like the tail, you live a tail, right? That's one disc in your spine. It's all set up like this. The disc in the spine is then sealed. That's why the discs in the spines are sealed. And then another disc goes on top of that as you begin to develop another life. And this is your process through what people call the ecosystem as you're evolving, right? Okay, so each of these discs are then sealed. So when you go through a kundalini awakening, the seals break. So all of the memories and the recollections and all the pain and the suffering and the wars and all that you've been through in developing those disc planes, timelines, flat earths, whatever you want to call them, all come back in a rush. And the being has to be willing to deal with that. The being has to be willing to confront that. You see? So that's why these activations have always been so, you know, you need real people that know how to do that. You don't need to be up in some place where somebody didn't certify themselves as the shaman. And then now, because they just did a couple of ceremonies and now they think they can go and administer the ceremony. And then all of a sudden you unlock the disc or break the seals on someone who has dealt with several past lives of retribution of being on one side and the other. And now all that's coming out in front of you. And a person spitting up green goo and acting like things that you've never even seen before. I mean, come on. But that would be your lesson for tampering with things that are greater than the maturity that you have achieved thus far. You see what I mean? And then the lessons will play out. And so this is how it works. The other thing that you have to realize. Okay. Just making sure. The next thing is that, so another thing to realize is that this is why the world, because they're switching over from trinary to binary, which I'm telling you is happening around the clock at every single moment to thousands of people. It's why now it even feels like, as I mentioned earlier, that when you go out and when you start, you go to the store, or maybe you got to go somewhere and check on a couple things, and you start assessing or pinging the people in the environment with you, it just seems like that they're on the deepest level of sleep. And that even what they do and how they carry on is even further away than they were yesterday. And this is because when you remove that that originality, you get then the begetting of more ignorance, and people begin to become dependent on the system, okay? Because now that they're dependent on the binary system, they must pull power from the system. So in order for them to, for the system to power them, they must stay in duality. And that's why it's the red versus blue. This team versus this team, Lakers versus the Knicks, or, you know, all this versus going on in the reality, male versus female, cat versus dog, rabbit versus fox. So all that, the whole system becomes corrupted, okay? And then what happens from there is you get a Donald Trump situation. Meaning you get where I call this the negative side of time travel, because if you really understand these beings that we're dealing with, just because they achieved time travel didn't make them more advanced. You see what I mean? Because technology has been existing for billions of years, or even before time, time travel is not the height of technology. Time travel is like lucid dreaming. Time travel is actually a little bit lower on the rung than many of the abilities, whether you know it or not. You actually see yourself across the timeline more often than you don't if you're really paying attention to what goes on in the sleep. But what happens when you can physically move into the future or in ahead of others is you get, how could I put this? You get the negative side of time travel, okay? Because this means then that someone who doesn't have the experience, they just have the time jump, is now managing the reality, okay? And this will actually answer more questions for you about the immaturity behind these leaders, so-called leaders. Like, again, Donald Trump. Now, how is a person that basically is ignorant and immature and programmed and basically devoid of any kind of real level of consciousness, just a yes man, going to manage elders? Meaning that still in some households, you got 80-year-old, 90-year-old people who are still on trinary systems. They've always maintained through their real culture, not the fake cultures, not the surrogate mothers, but they've maintained through their culture a real understanding of the power in which they have, and it is hard-coded within them. But you can put a leader in front of them that has none of that experience. And then we wonder, why are things off balance? And it's because you have people that have time traveled. See, this is the word you should put for it. When anyone that is not ordained and designed to be in a specific position has somehow been elevated into that position. That's time travel. That means that you skip the time that is necessary for you to have to go through the experiences that will put you into that place and allow you to manage that place in that position properly. Okay, so time travel is not always jumping in a machine and then coming out when dinosaurs are there. It's using things like technology, using things like mind control and hypnosis and all this to put a person or a being ahead of everyone else in the reality, and then have those people managing the reality, even though there are those who have went through the experience and are very well equipped to manage and to take care of this reality, meaning that there are still the great mothers and the great fathers, the divine feminine and the divine masculine forces that are being snuffed out in this reality, and they are still in a position to be able to guide and train and allow the reality to learn what it needs to know. But you have these binaries coming in, and they're time traveling ahead of everyone, putting themselves into positions that they have not gained the maturity to be in. And then there you have it as the rulers of the planetary system. Okay, so that's what time travel is. It's using things that propel one to the future, that give them a heightened stance over others who have gained the experience of how to go through those experiences, but then placing themselves as the leaders and the rulers over those people, Okay? And I just wanted to make sure that gets across for those who need to understand the whole reality of the time travel and how that really works. The next thing is, it's a lot. Man, it's a lot to do this. Like, I mean, sometimes I just, you know, I just am like, man, you know, because of the amount of stuff that I have to contend with on a daily basis, just from like all the extra going on, I'm like, man, you know, woe to a world that confuses its allies as its enemies. Like right now, I do what you see me do, and more have I become the enemy in the dualistic mind, binary mindset of the overall conscious community. Okay, so just so you understand, my position here does equal pain, but I'm immune to it. And it's not because I've shut off my system, it's because of continuously strengthening myself. So I suggest you do the same thing. You know, this is the buckle in for the ride that we're on here of assisting people with things that they need, but they don't know it yet. So here we are. So the next thing to realize also, and this is the big one, is that this reality that you're looking at right now, and even this physical body that you're seeing right now, and even the one that you can look at right now with your own eyes, actually is not the real one. It's just not. And only until you start blowing open some of these chakras and opening up some of these blockages do you actually start to see the real one. And when you start to see the real one, there will be certain things that you notice. Now, I'm going to tell you what's happening with the human beings when you open the third eye and you take a look at what's going on around them, because they have a lot of extra company, especially the ones who are the most off balance, okay, into the polarities. It's, first of all, you gradually watch something begin to develop around them, which I'm just calling the husk. It's very similar to the cocoon phase of the metamorphosis of a worm into a butterfly, except these are not going to become butterflies. And few of them will ever make it out the husk. And this is why we often refer to when a person goes into a high vibration that they crack the shell, because that shell is a husk. And let me tell you where it comes from. The binary technology begins to develop a field around the person in order to allow there to become a hybridization between the trinary and the binary fields. And the husk plays the module in which that communication begins to take place, because trinary and binary beings don't meld very well at all. It no more than you can just become your cell phone all of a sudden, like a physical iPhone 5 sitting here right now, and you didn't turn yourself into this huge piece of silicone and aluminum. It doesn't happen, right? So there is a transition phase, aka the husk. And the husk is being developed in real time around any being. That's why you're constantly encouraged to clean your system, clean your filters, stay in a high vibratory frequency to keep the husk from building up around you. Because what the husk does is, first of all, it is the organism itself that cuts you off from source. It builds up around you as a shell. Some people see it as gray in their astral eye. They see it as a gray field beginning to build up around the person. But when you turn on the third eye even more, it actually becomes organic in a way, meaning it looks like something insectoid, more or less. And in that field, and this is what is meant in the matrix by the person is inside of a pod. Okay? This pod is a husk that develops around them that becomes the direct result of 1, engaging in binary activity, 2, eating genetically modified foods, 3, pumping the physical body and the physical system full of low quality heavy metals, 3, anger and jealousy in lower frequencies when they become stagnant within the system, 6, meat or scared meat, putting meat into the system that makes the system inherit all the pain of another organism. Okay, so you're getting an idea of how a husk is developed. But make no mistake, if you keep thinking that this is all there is, the body is all there is, that's what they love to say, is I'm not the body, then what are we? Well, you need to go up into the higher frequency to see what we are. And don't be surprised if when you're in that frequency, see, high frequency just means truth. It doesn't mean that you're now going to be in a land of flowing with milk and honey and damsels with beautiful eyes and all this. It doesn't mean that. You have to make, you have to create that. You have to originate that. The only thing high frequency is truth. It means that when you see something, now you see it as it is. Not the cloaks, not all of the invisibility, not all of the misperceptions, misconceptions, the fake programming and all that that a person has encased themselves with. Because again, if a person just wears all white and then, you know, and gets their face done enough, they can be looking like a namaste-er in no time. Namaste, I'm peace and I'm light. But then you can go into another framework of truth and see that the person is a subdomain being. Because the subdomain. Okay, so that's what this is really about. High frequency means truth. So when the husk begins to develop around the being, they can't vibrate because it's a form of compression, just like what you deal with in a computer. It's attempting to compress the being so that there can be more space for more compression. And that's why computers compress things into blocks or cubes and stack them all up. Like on Wall-E, they stack the trash up and it's easier to stack it up in cubes because they can get more space. Same thing in a computer. When you compress, it compresses into a cubic language in order for there to be more compression. So in the reality, the husks compress the being, cut them off from their originality so they don't ever create nothing new. They all say the same thing. Oh, dude. Oh, man, I'm stoked. Oh, man. Oh, great. Oh, let's do this. And it's just that kind of reality where once something trends, then everyone is doing it. That's compression. Okay? So the husk compresses, it cuts off. And your job, your duty, your service, etc., is to crack that husk through frequency. Now you can do this with your own frequency. You could teach the person if they're in ability to learn how to raise their frequency so they start breaking it. But it's a simple thing. This is not so complex as people make it. This is a frequency war. So to win the war, be the master of frequency. So this is what we're going to be talking about here in just a moment. There's a couple more things to make sure that we translate, and then we're going to go into the second part of this. And I'm going to speed things up as much as possible just for those that do need to get on to something else today. So just remember, what causes these shells is all this, or the husk, is the genetically modified foods and all these different things beginning to become static around them, because all this stuff is frequency first. And what physicality is the solidification of frequency, right? Physicality means everything here is a sound, and then once it's slowed down to a certain point, it becomes physical. So when you eat certain things, GMO, mercury, all this stuff, it is a frequency, and then it eventually becomes static around you. It clogs your arteries, it blocks your mind states, it shuts down your neurological network. But spiritually, that takes place first. So just remember, every time you eat one of these things, every time you think like that binary thought, it's already happening to your spiritual self. Don't depend on the physicality being so accurate at representing to you what's going on in real time. Physicality has a lag because it is far from truth. Okay, the moment the reality starts becoming true again, then we'll start seeing what's really going on. But in its falsehood, you're seeing a slowed down dense vibration that could happen thousands of years ago in the level that we're on. And that could also be misleading to what's taking place in real time. It's like checking the weather from a year ago in order to try to figure out what's going on today. That's not how you do things. You must move to that other level so you can see what's going on in real time and in truth. That's why I tell people, you can't handle the truth. And it's because of this. Because again, when you look at all of what I'm saying and you go forth from this conversation today, you're going to see it all around you. And you'll also see how you're protected from it, because you protect yourself. And we're going to get into it a little bit here about protection from these kind of binary life forms, but I must give you their identity, their total identity. So also remember, what builds this husk, and this is why you have to do constant maintenance to yourself while you're here. Okay, addendum here. A lot of people wonder, why is there no light beings in the reality? Like, why is there so, when is something coming to save us? My good friends, you're gonna have to save yourself. We're all here to assist in real time, but we're also coming from the sickness, meaning that I came out of this just like you're coming out of this. And that's how we made our progress. We didn't, this huge light being, you know, here and, you know, sitting in circles and people are there and, you know, I'm turning water into wine and all this kind of stuff. That's not the profile. That's not the story. And it's because so few, if any, beings that have already achieved the total realization of what is going on vibratory frequencies like this one are going to agree to come back into a vibratory frequency like this, where there's going to be a high probability of chance that they're not going to be able to survive. This is like once you eat organic food and once you drink good water and once you breathe clear air for a prolonged period of time, and then you're going to go down to New York and then act like nothing's going to happen. That's not how this works. Every action deserves a reaction in these frequencies. So thus what I'm saying is that you have to be what you're looking for. It's not going to all of a sudden show up. It's not going to be throwing light all over the place and destroying these creatures that I'm telling you about. It's going to be you doing that. And you're going to do it with a way of harmonics, not duality. You're not going to move back into a binary field trying to get rid of something that wants you to be binary. You see? Think of the keys here. Most of these people, these religions, these structures, the New Age, etc., they have binary ways of trying to handle the situation on the planet, when the only thing that is purporting all this foolishness is the binary stage of consciousness. You must get the most powerful weapon, if you may, which is harmony, the balancing rod that causes the vibrations of balance. And that's your body. You're the caudaceous staff. So your perfection of balance in harmonics that you've achieved within yourself becomes the panacea or the cure for anyone that you come across or is fortunate enough to grace your presence. That's how this works. So, but even for that being, and this is why I mentioned that, even for that being, when they achieve that state, they must constantly be on guard. They must constantly do the maintenance that's necessary on the bodies in order to maintain their status here as someone that is here to assist, because it's coming out of the back of the cars. It's coming out of someone's cigarette. It's coming out of the food that someone may try to serve you. So this is why you always have to end up doing the maintenance, because it's until the environment is purified again, meaning made free of all things that are causing disharmony. Okay? It takes a lot of energy to do this. And it's just because, you know, talking does, you know, when you're talking about something serious, your whole being is so focused into it. And, you know, because I have a lot of passion, you know, tied into what we've been doing for the last 7 years, and it grows and it gets stronger and stronger. It's like I don't find myself getting more deterred and more weary from doing this. I find myself getting more innovative and more strengthened and more intelligent and more originative. I guess that's not a word. I'll originate that word. More originative at doing something different. Like if something that doesn't work here, then we have to analyze it. And now that I have so many blueprints to what's going on in different aspects of the reality, it's much more easier to find solutions for all of us. But that's also been because of taking the pain of when coming to the realization of certain things and not just denying it as not true and sticking my head in the sand, but instead enduring it until I can actually get through it and then begin to find a solution. So let me keep going here. So now we come to the ancient part of this, okay? Because like I said, this technology is not new. It's been going on for millions of years, even before time. And so we need to understand how the ancients put this so that you can connect and so you won't believe that this is something that's actually just happening right now, but it's actually been progressing over thousands and thousands of years on our particular planetary system. It's because once the husk develops around the being and it begins to integrate the binary life form into the trinary, thus downgrading this trinary life form or whole being, That particular entity becomes what is known as a demon, okay? The divided one, okay? And this is because all binary life forms can be seen as a demon. That's why when you go into the computer system, when you go into the deep recesses of its software and firmware, you'll find commands that begin with daemon. Look at the computers. They start daemon, and then from daemon, you begin to code certain things. Okay, just to let you see that it's actually embedded within these systems. What I'm telling you is not as far-fetched as you think it is when you understand everything or understand everything going on around you and not neglecting that, hey, I'm just going to use this. I don't know anything about it. Like you can pull open one of these cell phones right now and you just see this thing. And even if it's broke, you don't even come close to knowing how to fix it. Versus with a machine, let's say, for instance, like an old mechanical car like the Model T, when something breaks, you're going to see physically what broke. You're going to see the magneto fused together. Or you're going to see the engine piston stuck or bent. You're going to see maybe some line between the battery burned. You're going to see something physically. But now with this new technology, when it breaks, you look at it and you're like, man, it looks like it's brand new. Like, I don't know what's wrong with it. And then it takes them to go and interface with it through software to run diagnosis to figure out what actually failed and what piece is failing. Okay. So that's an analogy of understanding how this keeps advancing. It's becoming to a point where we can't look physically at something and see what's really wrong with it. Okay. So what happens is if you can't do that with people, that's why the greatest healers, they can see you and they can see what's wrong with you. Okay, this is part of those abilities. So what happens is that with a person who begins to go binary, they turn into a daemon. And then from that point, basically the person becomes an altered image of themselves. Okay, so it's the inorganic form of the soul. Okay, it's the inorganic form of the soul. So remember, if the whole purpose between souls and spirits are for the spirits to be reflections of the soul, what the daemon is the daemon is a reflection of the spirit. You see what I mean? So it's like two levels down. And in that process, it's actually become binary. And that's why demons have always been denoted as being bad, because the other ones, because the other beings you roll into this are obviously angels, okay? Because that's the whole binary program, angels and demons, okay? But truthfully, if you go into the Persian text, they were all demons. There was no actual deviation between one or the other, okay? So what happens is that because then you'll be dealing with this alter image of them, it's not actually really them. So this is why if you go into retribution, if you go into physical war, if you go into hollering at them and screaming at them and mad at them, now you've been taken over too and assimilated, because now you're going to use the same method that caused them to be the way they are to try to speak to something that they're not even. They're no longer there. See, this is why the binary forms need trinary beings to originate bodies and to create the life, the heart, okay? But then after that process, they attempt to remove as much of that wholeness from the being so that the only thing that remains is just the will to stay alive, which is what we do. We stay alive while most or the rest of the being is completely infected by another life form that is operating through them, generally and most always on a hive, meaning all the daemons, just like all the computers tied into the internet, are on hives. So there's a hierarchical system. That's why any magical book on black magic and pretty much any spiritual system, there is a hierarchy. And that's why that hierarchy is introduced. Okay? So then you have this hierarchy because, okay, so again, because so this is how systems are managed, is what I'm getting to here, is that when you have these reflections or images of something that's not even real within itself, then it's easy to master over something like that. That's why people find themselves, the masses find themselves so easily to be controlled, because they're not even themselves anymore. And then in that, they become susceptible to their masters. Okay, this is their presidents, This is, and remember, all these are people are also inhabited by a graduation of a hierarchical structure of beings that have this happen to them. Okay? So, you know, it can get a little complex here, but not really. Because when you look into all the systems, the doctrines and the dogmas, they all exhibit the same hierarchical structure. And the only thing different is a few name changes. And it's because there must be a mainframe to manage all the rest of the other systems, just like the soul must manage all the spirits. So this is a replica. Okay, this is the replication, but artificial replication. And this is why people are saying, well, it's an illusion. It's an illusionary world. And it's because it's being gradually made that way through this process that I'm speaking to you about right now. And there are individuals, well, you can't even call them individual anymore, propagating this process of total assimilation. And you'll see it all around you. So the next thing is, that's also why demons have always been depicted as slaves. And then their masters, and then they have these masters. So in history, there's always been the archons, but they've always been seen also as genetic modifications themselves. The story behind the archons is they didn't grow up inside of the womb. They didn't grow up inside of Gaia. Okay? And so thus, this allowed them to lack the connection, the empathy, the compassion, the heat, the warmth, all of that, that all the beings that are created through Gaia have. So what are we saying? We're saying the story of technology. Technology, computers are not birthed from Earth and from the womb of Earth in natural life. They are creations. So it's the same thing with the archonic forces. They didn't go through the process of organic biological life. They are binary beings. Okay, this is how you tie that in and to solve that riddle. So the archons are AI, artificial intelligence. Artificial in the sense that not that it's not real, but artificial in the sense to that it's, well, that's funny. Artificial not in the sense that it's not real, but artificial in the sense to that, this is crazy because English uses the same word. So what I'm basically saying is that this, it's a replica. The archons are in a sense replicas of the original womb, and that's what makes them artificial, because they're not the originals, okay? That's called a surrogate, right? It's like the process that you can go through to birth something in a petri dish. It doesn't actually get a real womb. It gets the process of how things come into creation, but not by what creates it, okay? And the archons, who are generally trapped outside of biological worlds, because remember, they can't meld well with trinary. So they, when we say trapped outside, we're saying that they can't even get in because it doesn't mesh well. So the only way it can mesh together is to wear a body or a world, which has always been seen also as the body, is then degraded to a state to where it becomes harmonic with the binary consciousness and binary way of being, okay? So it's all very simple, and it connects together. So lastly, some last few things here to understand is that, and as far as the process of the archons, it's very similar to, because their infection or their virus is power and control, it has corrupted them. So what corruption is, if you want to understand it in this tense, okay, still on. What corruption is, if you want to understand it in this tense, is corruption is when you have a formula, let's say a recipe, okay, we'll make it very simple, a cooking recipe. Let's say you put this recipe together and the recipe is perfect. And then someone comes behind you and says, well, but let's add this salt. And they dump a cup of salt in there, a whole cup. So now something that would have been a perfect formula is now drastically imperfect. So now you're getting closer to what the archons really are. So what the archons are beings who once were trinary, and through their meddling, which is their story, their meddling within the genome, genetics, DNA, not accepting that everything is perfect, okay? began to take on or infuse themselves with traits that they felt would be make them more powerful than others. So now already going down that road again. They call that a fallen one. So how this works is, for instance, in the chameleon, and again, this is doing this with spirits, okay? Not with the soul, but with spirits. It's the spirits carrying on. So the chameleon has this ability to camouflage itself, okay? And now let's say everyone on the planet is not a chameleon. Everyone doesn't have that ability to camouflage themselves directly in physical reality. So what an archon would do is take that genetic structure and attempt to infuse itself with that genetic structure in order to have more power over everything else, because it actually has now the ability to be chameleon. It could be the same thing as venom from scorpions, taking the genetic structure of what allows you to have venom and then infusing that into your genetic structure. So you can see that rather rapidly, which is what many of the ancient books denote, is that there became a corruption within their system because they were throwing off a formula that was perfect. Like the weights and the measures of what's in that being is then thrown off by them adding too much of something. And then they create this imbalance. And through that imbalance, it corrupts. Like if you can see it like software, it begins to corrupt the software, so the software breaks down. Then no longer can it even realize its original purpose. And then it continues to try to infuse itself more and more with what can give it power, and to a point where it only can feed on lower power systems. Okay, so this is what you need to understand about, these are called the hideous side effects of the archons. This is why the archons are always denoted as being chimeras, which is basically created, not just a being that's created of specific composites, but also being a mixture of different things, a spider, cat, whatever, because there's what they're saying is there's a genetic imbalance there to where this being is trying to take the genetics of things that it feels like are more powerful and infuse that genetics in them until they become a collective of that being, aka a mutant. And then somehow in that mutant transformation, as it always happens when you're tampering with perfection, there's this breakdown to where there's a hideous form that comes from that, that is basically poisoned in the mind. You can see how all this happens. Look, it's happening today. All this what I'm talking to you about is happening now. The height of these people's technology in their mind is when they can finally blend this computer and Google right into their consciousness in their mind, so they can Google from their brain. That's their spirituality. That's the binary level of consciousness. That's how it thinks. So I'm saying, when you can adapt in a tense, simulate for a second how it thinks, you can see how it would do this kind of thing. It's gonna, just like the Queen of England and all the rest of them, they're gonna try to find the most powerful and strongest thing and then adapt or try to associate with it, right? And they've already become corrupted. They try to take the lion, they try to take this and that and the other, and then because if it's a biological organism and they're binary, it generally doesn't mesh well with them unless they do some modifications. And these modifications are the brainwashing, the mind control, the GMO. All those are the modifications in order to take or assess or command and control different levels of abilities. But then, because it never works in the first place, the system corrupts and breaks down of not only the being doing that, but also the ones that they're doing it to. Okay? And that's why you get this. It's almost like dealing with abused children in the world, because everyone is breaking down because of the abuse that's taking place in their reality. Because think about it, how much of a person's consciousness daily is actually their own? You get up in the morning, you rush around, get yourself dressed, maybe take the kids to school if you got kids, get them ready or get them off to the bus, cook breakfast, or don't cook anything, just pour some stuff out of a box, throw some stuff in the microwave. This is the standard life of the average individual. I'm not talking about people who understand about what microwaves do and what GMO does. So they put the stuff together. We should have compassion on them. We should have empathy for them. They put the stuff together, and then they get in their car, they drive off, and they get stuck in traffic. So here they are in this stressful thing because they're going to be late to work. If they be late to work again, they're going to get fired. Then they get the kids. They're yelling at the kids, shut up. The kids are going all crazy because they've been eating these Fruit Loops, and the Fruit Loops got them loopy. And then they kick them out of the car, and then they drive off to work. They get to the job, and then from that point on, or even before that started, it's dictation. So now they got to go into this same specific role that they've been commanded to do from someone else that generally has nothing to do with their own progress, like we talked about during the last meeting. And then they get their little lunch break, which is small. Generally, they try to do something else besides eat lunch on that break, something that they need also to get done. So they're stressing through that. They're eating all this food, but none of that food has been prepared by grandma or anyone who had any love for anything. So then they put the genetics into their body. It starts to modify them. They're all angry and upset. It melds perfectly. You see? If they're angry, they're upset, they're stressful, it melds. If they're whole, they're pure, they get a reaction. This ain't good. They throw it up. They get headaches. They get all these commands from their body, organic body, saying, hey, yo, don't eat that. But if they're already in binary, stressed out, angry, upset, it melds perfectly. This is why, this is your answer to why people can eat garbage, basically, and still be okay, while some people who eat organic food feel sick. This is why, because it's about how much genetic modification has really gone on and how well is that being melding with that genetic modification. So then they let them all off at work at the same time, 5 o'clock, 6 o'clock. Now everyone's stuck in traffic again, all angry, all pissed off, trying to get there, not to be late to pick up the kids again. And then they get home. I'm sure there's no great relationship going on with this kind of thing with the mother and the father, so the kids are getting that too. And then they all sit down for this dinner that probably comes out of the microwave again. And then from that point, the person has about 1 to 2 hours to do something that may be about them, which generally is turning on the TV or turning on Facebook and taking in some more of the programming. And then they turn it off, and then they go to sleep maybe for 6 hours to do it up again, do it all over again. And you tell me, you're trying to ask me why people are off and crazy, and even to try to justify that craziness, meaning try to justify that everything in the reality is okay, something's wrong with you then. Because even on the weekend, they can then, as an entertainment, only go to places that actually mean that they're going to be hurt. Mall, M-A-L-L, right? Did we not see that mall means to basically be like a bear just mauled you, or a lion just mauled you, right? Club. Did we just not see that a club is something you can get hit over the head with? So they go to the mall, they go to the club. That is their entertainment. Every single aspect of the reality, something is dictating to them. And you're telling me that, and I'm just saying hypothetically, you're telling me that what I'm telling you today is not going on, and it may be a figment of my imagination, when I'm not immersed in any of that and have not been for the last 6 years? To the point where I can start seeing clear. You know, you do all the work on yourself until you finally you start seeing clear. This is years of deprogramming to finally realize the precipice of what the hell's going on in the reality. So I'm translating it to you so you can cut down. That's positive time travel. Cut down the process of what you would need to have to learn it and then get into the experience, which honestly, all of us are in the experience right now. We just need to understand what we're experiencing here. So, continuing, okay, just making sure we're still connected here on the live stream. So, then we need to realize that once a being's been put through all that, now they become binary. Now they're computers. They're basically zeros and ones. They're always looking for things to quarrel with and fight and argue with and just basically oscillate between their zero and one poles. And because of that, this is also why they need a battery. And this is something that you need to pay attention to, because this is what goes on in the invisible world. If you want to know what's going on, what's invisible, can somebody that can see please tell me? Can I use your eyes to see? Can I stand on your shoulders to see farther? If you did, you would then see that most of these beings, if not all of them, then need batteries, because they need to power themselves off of this. And batteries of a tenth to like what bass is, okay? Because if I play anything over 20,000 hertz to you, you can't hear it. If I play one hertz to you, you can hear it and feel it. And bass, so that's what bass is. Bass is like lower vibratory frequency, so it's like boom, 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 and you can feel it, okay? And when you go into the negatives with bass, then you get distortion, okay? So what happens is that the battery that binary beings need to fill themselves up with is actually of that caliber. It's like electricity. You know how electricity is hissing and spitting? It's very nasty kind of energy. Just like oil is very nasty kind of energy. It's not magnetics. You see what I mean? So when something needs that kind of power, if you want to understand how they get that from other organisms that have their batteries too, that they need to get charged. So it's basically, hey, let me steal your power. This is the game that they're playing out there in the world, that people are playing. And this is how they do it. Piss you off. They want to piss you off. They just want to get you angry. They just want to get you upset. They just want to not agree with something that you're saying. And they want you to feel like it's so imperative for you to get that across to them that now you're affected by it. And now you're going to go right into this argument in exchange of heat, fire, flame, and energy and negativity with them so they can eat. Because whoever wins eats more. But all lose because they're still in the binary worlds with other entities attached to them. Remember, these are the riders. These are the ones when the trinary being is hybridized because it's got the husk on, then something attaches to them. And then that something, you can often even make that something come out of people in silence because it can't even remain silent. You could be somewhere in your deep meditation and then somebody else is there and then they come in and they're sitting there watching you in your meditation and they can even pretend like they're in meditation. Then all of a sudden they'll go like this. Something wild. And you'd be like, man, I'm meditating. You start thinking that in your mind. Man, I'm meditating. Be quiet over there. What is he doing? But now they already got you. Because now you go from your center state of being inside of yourself to now sending out what is photonic energy. So just so you understand how this works in the reality and where these energy transfers are going on at, is that when a person is in pain, when a person is disturbed, or when a person is being argued with, or when a person is in what we would call negativity, then they emit a certain kind of photon. It's even measurable. And that's where the power transfer is coming from, okay? So it's as simple as that. There's just a transfer. So if you can keep people from, if you can keep yourself, remember, it's not about, you know, trying to stop all of these people from doing this. It's about stopping yourself first from doing it so you can put yourself in a position to charge up long enough to where you can do it without having to exchange words or without having to go into some kind of conflict with the person. You see what I mean? So you need to build up your own system. But remember, as you're building it up, you start to become more and more aware of how many things are trying to take it. Because the more that you build, the more that it sparks the interest of others. And that's why they said those people who have a lot of energy, a lot of kundalini, etc., they attract others. And they're attracting them because those people at times are still addicted to energy. So this does become a process to take them through their transformation, but the adept is not clueless to what exactly is happening. It's just about beginning to allow those people to see that the same energy that you're generating is the same energy that they can generate. Right. So then you uncover the whole problem with the guru thing. The guru thing is, oh, well, this is the only I can generate this energy. I'll help you. I'll share it with you. But, you know, just because of the lowly state that you're on and because you don't know as much as I do, then, you know, you can't ever have this kind of energy. See, that's how that whole thing plays out. What we're doing is we're empowering people to come to the maximum realization that the same thing I'm doing, not only can you do, but also probably better. And in the event that I end up needing some assistance in this whole thing, maybe that you can come to my assistance in it and assist me with whatever I'm experiencing. You see what I mean? So it's about empowering each other so that way we all become strong pillars. So if something does crumble, it doesn't fall. You see what I mean? That's building the collective in the way that it should be. Let's keep going here. Now, we need to realize that, so this ancient system of what we're calling technology is actually black magic, okay? It's how black magic works. Black magic is one of the oldest systems of antiquity on the planet that actually highlight every single process of this exchange of energy transfer. It is about negativity, it is about duality, and it is about hierarchy. So if you look into reality and there's negativity, there's hierarchy, and there's all those things that I mentioned, this means that it's black magic. Now, another component of black magic is actually eating charred remains. And some people are like, what? Charred remains of flesh? What kind of crazy? Well, no, that's as crazy as what most people put on their plate every night. They burn this flesh, okay? And then they put that flesh into their system. They have no empathy for that animal and that being. And they have put carbon, burnt carbon in their body, which is still holding the memory. They used to call it scared meat, holding the memory of the entire process of what that entity just went through. This is no different than what the Vatican had done to build its walls. Was the mortar, was the ashes of the humans that were tortured during the Inquisition, just to keep the negativity and the stagnancy of the whole memory bank of that system that they're dealing with in place. So I am telling you, you know, because I for a little bit, I'm like, you know what, I'm just going to stop even saying it, because I've said it years and years and years. Get off the meat. You're not a carnivore. Your body is not even designed to be a carnivore. But there's more that's happening now with eating meat than could ever happen before. Well, actually, it's still all the same thing, but I'm just saying it adds another chink to your armor if you're eating this charred animal flesh and you're sustaining yourself on such low vibratory energy. You have to begin to, because that's why people think that they can't live off vegetables. It's the same way that a daemon doesn't believe it can live off the power that comes from photosynthesis in the sun. It's the same transfer of concept to where higher vibratory frequencies are not able to sustain the life form. When you're trinary and you're moving back into those fields, you can even sustain yourself off of some of the energetic components that are of the most purest caliber. But that's the roll back. And we've talked about that a lot, about going into the mineral kingdom and getting your minerals together, getting off the meat, going to the vegetables, and then starting to move to the minerals, and then starting to move into the water, then starting to move into the air, and then getting to the point where you can start to sustain yourself without large amounts of any of that stuff. That's the roll back home. Okay? So, last parts of this. I didn't know that this was this long. It's quite a message today. I mean, it's one that, you know, maybe some people need to rewind again, but I just feel like my consciousness cannot be clear unless the people who choose to listen to me and what I'm saying know. Because that's something that I did in the tense that nobody told me to go and start teaching people spiritual knowledge. That's something that I said I would do myself. And in that integrity, the integrity of my own personal obligation to myself, then I'm going to make sure all those that choose to listen to what I'm saying understand in real time the highest levels of what they need to know to progress in this reality and realities beyond. That's my promise to you. So, and promise to myself. So, now you understand why. So the minions, they can eat the meat. The minions, they can get into the arguments, and the minions can sustain themselves off of that vibratory that amount of low vibratory frequency. However, the archons, or the masters of the demonic black magic system, which is still in play, you'll see it all around as you begin to understand. The masters of that system, they cannot sustain themselves off just a simple argument. They must create mass war and genocide, because the frequencies that are present during that point are strong enough. Meaning that, so the energetic form of when a person is leaving their body for the final time in complete fear or being sacrificed is almost static, meaning it almost actually appears in the physical reality. They have books that were written about the phantoms on the war field, meaning that they will go to these fields that wars had taken place during World War I and World War II, right after the war, where all the plasma was still there. And then they would notice that they could actually begin to see these forms feeding on that energy. And it's because that energy is giving them enough energy for one moment to become to where you can see them before they fade back into that low vibratory frequency that they're on. So this is what you need to be aware of. That's what makes them invisible. It's not that they're more powerful. Like a lot of people say, well, shoot, they're invisible, so they must be more powerful. No, actually, invisibility is generally a result of not having enough power. Because once you have a lot of power, then you appear like the sun. Like the sun doesn't have a sunset. There's no sunset for the sun. It's not going to be invisible to anybody because it's too much power within it. So it's the same thing. If something's invisible, it's because it's depleted most of its power and reached into a phantom realm. And the moment that it actually is able to assess or gain any kind of energetic that it can harmonize with, which is this low vibratory frequencies plasma that is infused with fear and pain, like what I was saying about eating food, it makes them more static. So for a human being who is engaging also in those practices, it also keeps you earthbound and body bound more, to where that kind of person who's eating those kind of things and putting that kind of stuff into their system, they can't actually escape the concept of physicality. Do you see what I'm saying? So that's how that works from the seen, for the seen and unseen. So again, the burst of the biophotons that emit from a being when they suffer or die appears at first like a shock wave. And that shock wave is then like a spray of energy for these lower life forms that feed on that energy. And in short, they basically want to make us suffer so that they can live in this ghastly ghost state that they're already in. So be on your guard. Be on your guard, not for death and all those things, because you're far away from that generally. It's any kind of level of energy transfer on a negative level. If someone wants to fight with you, argue with you about something, degrade you, debase you, and it's getting underneath your skin, get out of there. Because as you begin to build your energetic field, it will affect you less and less and less and less and less and less, and then you'll start to shine. The moment that you allow your body to recharge, and then now that you're aware of all this, because the reason why it had to come across so serious today, demons, black magic, the whole nine, it's like, are we at a Spiritek meeting or are we at a show? And it's because you need to realize how important your energy is to you before you can realize how important it may be even to others. You see, as far as them needing your assistance, because if you're all off guard all the time, and then the moment that someone says something, your kundalini is being used for negativity and hatred and envy, then you still are in the system. You're just a stronger battery. So remember that. It's, people try to do it to me, so they're going to try to do it to you. They're going to try to do it to anyone they can. And this is when you wise up to realizing what's going on, then you're able to realize what's actually happening. And then from that point, you begin to restore yourself. You see what I mean? Like your body starts to charge back up and your system begins to modify itself back to its original form. It will return to its original state as long as it's not constantly receiving holographic images of the debased binary state. Okay, so just remember that. We're finally at the last part. Whew. To remember that our children are in the greatest danger because they didn't actually have, because the system is getting more and more aggressive, they don't even have parents that will protect them from the vaccinations. They don't have parents that will protect them from the TV. They don't have parents that will explain to them the dualistic reality and what ultimately this, you know, choosing one team over another, choosing one rapper over another, choosing whatever, always the choosing is really doing to their energetic system. So we're looking at the final generation, really. Spiritex and whoever else understands this knowledge are not going to move in, then we will lose this one. This is the ultimate reality of this, meaning that there are people who are already gone. There are people who are already assimilated. So again, waking up out of Wonderland is waking up out of this idea that everything is not real and that it's just all happening around you to entertain you for some reason. This is a real thing, and what you do about it does weigh on how your consciousness develops. So it's very important for us to realize that our children are being attacked by these binary life forms and by their whole idea and system of hierarchy and control. So if we don't move in, this is how serious it is. Start putting the kids on that list of what we are losing here rather than just yourself all the time. So that's a direct statement to understanding who's getting hit with this the most. It's not you. So if you're over there feeling sorry for yourself, if you're over there even feeling sorry for other people that are grown-ups, then you need to also start thinking about the children, because they don't even have a way of protecting themselves from this. Okay, so just realize that. The last thing here is that what you'll witness is that because a lot of people are sharing their bodies with these binary forms, they can also be triggered. So the moment that generally something upsets them, that triggers them. The moment that they see something, it triggers them. So also even watch yourself. If you find yourself being triggered really easy by certain things, this means that you may need to go and do some high vibratory process on yourself again to make sure that your system is clear of those kind of organisms. So it's a real thing that you have to watch out for yourself. We talked about what fracking is really about and how it's destroying Earth's ley lines. So, and they're fracking right now. So this means that as you're witnessing, there becomes less and less connectivity that people have to the Earth and to the soul of the Earth. And so what happens from there is that you still are that front line of defense, because if you have that connection, then they can still receive that connection through you. So you're the bridge, you're the ley line. So remember that, like, as they're breaking the organics systems, we are still filling in the gaps by maintaining original, like the source. So that concludes the first part of today's meeting. And the second part actually is not going to be that long, but I'm going to go ahead and get right into it. I'm going to switch screens very briefly here. And what this is about is just a brief look at our internal cleansing products, which I said we were going to talk about today, just to see how those internal cleansing products are capable of assisting a person with the situation that they may be experiencing in the reality. So I'm going to go ahead and show a screen here of what goes on the site. And before I do that, let me just check the chat box real quick, make sure everything is still in line. And so let me just take a moment before we transition right into this, which again is not going to take me but a moment, because we're just going to cover one topic. And the reason is also that this is all going to really make sense, because yes, we will get into a more detailed explanation of every single product, and we hope to make videos of those products so that you can share them with other people that want to know more about them. But after the conversation for today, you get the overarching gist of the entire mission, which is raise the vibratory frequency of the planet. So if someone, like today's conversation, it gave you so many details, for some it could be quite complex. But to simplify it, let's say, well, somebody says, well, out of all that, what you just said, what is the main thing that you want me to take from that? Raise your vibratory frequency and the frequency of others as much as possible. That is your service. That is what you do. That is your pleasure. And when you do that, you will see the abundance, not just monetary, but in every single way that abundance exists, because you'll be tapping back or forward into the original source. Now you know what's going on with why all this stuff is going on in the reality. No one can debunk you on this. Like, you're going to even answer questions that nobody has been baffled and puzzled by, as you keep unraveling what is taking place in the reality within these cabals, within the black magic systems, within the polarization in the binary fields of wars, turmoil, chaos. You now have the origins of all of that. And you don't just have that. You don't have just the knowledge. Because what Spiritek is about is not only the knowledge, but also the remedy. So the major part of the remedy is not these products. The products can assist and do a very good job at it, but the major part of the remedy is you. Each person that you interact with needs to see what it's like to be real again. There's so few examples of it. So that, in every essence, is what they gain the most. They gain a companion. They gain a true friend in this reality that is going to tell them about what's going on with them, whether they even like it or not. And then they'll learn as they continue to progress. If you tell someone the truth, even if they leave you right then and hate you for it, it won't be long before they'll be right back thanking you. Thank you for being real. Thank you for not just telling me what I want to hear. You see? So, and the people, there's people out there now, you know, the more money you have, the more pretty you are, the worse off it's going to be. Because that separates more and more you from truth. Because people will not tell you the truth if you have millions of dollars. People will not tell you the truth if you're over there looking like the perfect five. They're like, oh man, they don't want to say anything to offend you. You're a star and an actor. They don't want to say anything to offend you just because you may take them off your friends list. You see what I mean? So that means the person gets further separated from truth. And that's why spirit text will generally be in places with people who have a great deal of influence over things in the world. Third degree of separation in intense. They know someone that knows someone. Because when you have truth, we're all in need of it. And if there's a bit, which is always going to be a bit of the real whole being still left in that creation or in that life form, then they will resonate with it. And because of what we know now, it has to be in there, even if it's completely suppressed. The real one of them is still in there, and that is what you're appealing to. That is exactly what's going to recognize you, because it's going to see itself, okay? And it's going to see an ally. So that's what I had to say about that. So getting into this, very briefly, internal cleansing, what you should understand, because many of the products everyone's already read through, some people have tried them, they already know about them. You see now we have the regeneration salve and the regeneration spray. And what that is actually formulas for cell regeneration that are bona fide. Like if anyone has taken the opportunity to rub some of this magnesium, zeolite, arnica, lobiella cream on anything on their body that may be hurting or inflamed, even skin problems, rashes, and then, of course, promoting absorption of not only the solar light, but also the stars, because that's photosynthesis. So it may seem, it doesn't seem far-fetched. You just need to study your stuff. Like the guy that put this together is actually, he knows his stuff. He knows formulas. He's been working with formulas for 30, 40 years. He was first working with formulas to perfect horse hair. That's what they had him doing. He created something called tail and mane. Many people have known this product. They've seen it even in hair supply stores, but it was basically the top equestrian product, basically to get the horse's mane and the horse's hair looking all lush and beautiful. And through that process, he began to figure out how cells grow and what goes on when cells die. And then he had a process in his life to where he caught a cancer. And he was in the final stages. You know, they say the stages, you know, you're gone. You got a few more days. You need to tell everyone goodbye. And in that process, he had already uncovered this secret to this magnesium. And he was still just going through it. And he decided, well, look, just get this nurse to rub this cream on me every day. And from that point, he began a rapid recovery. The guy's name is Warren Chambers. You can check him out on the internet. If you go Warren Chambers cancer, you'll find him. And you'll see that they have the documentation, because all the doctors came in there after that. You know how they do. They act like they want to know the truth But then at the end of the day, they really don't, because they just want to play around in the binary world again. But the reality is that he beat it twice. And now he's alive and kicking and doing his thing. And then I got linked up with him with another brother that was in the network that tied me into him. And then we started building about this. And then he decided that he wanted to create it for secret energy. And so we were able to create this. Now, again, what it does is it absorbs. So magnesium, the profile magnesium is extensive. Like, we couldn't even have 4 or 5 hour show and begin to sum up how magnesium is needed in the body and is one of the chief components of deficiency within the human body. And because of that, then the process of things like photosynthesis, the human body is like a plant. It needs to process solar light. It needs to process light into energy. And when it doesn't have magnesium, it can't do that. So then then comes depression. Then comes needing to sleep. Then also more magnesium the body becomes more and more magnesium deficient. It's like a vicious cycle. When you're depressed, when you argue a lot, when you're angry, your body leaches magnesium from your liver and your kidneys. Basically, the magnesium comes out of the system. It's the way the system has to attempt to heal itself. But that means the more arguments and the more stress and stressful realities, the less magnesium. And then the more depressed, the less magnesium. So we're talking about a vicious cycle. We're probably talking about 95% of the people in the world being magnesium deficient. And on top of that, magnesium is a diuretic. So you can't just keep eating magnesium, because magnesium also is, you know, you're going to diarrhea. It's going to cause you to evacuate. So also the magnesium will be lost in that process or soaked up inside of the stomach lining. So the best way to absorb magnesium is actually through the largest organ in the body, which is the skin. And when you begin to absorb that, then it gets into the areas that would never be able to be reached if you took it topically, or even if you took it through the mouth. So that's one item. That's the magnesium zeolite. And then you have two formats. You have the cream, you have the spray, because some people are constantly on the go, so they just, you know, they can spray the knee. Athletes, so remember also this particular cream product is already being used, I think, by like 8 or 9 NFL teams. And they ran it through their whole process, because despite they will damn near kill one of these players, when it comes time to administer any kind of something else to them that they don't know about, then they call in all their doctors and they get all these tests done. And so they did all of that with this particular product, and they were basically blown away by it. And they now have it at most of these camps to, when these guys get off the field, because all their muscles are pretty much torn up and they've taken hits and all that kind of stuff. This is the most rapid recovery for that. So this is real regeneration cream, okay? And then the spray, obviously, is a different application. And then one of the things that's also offered is just the salts, because as it was explained to me, Epson is actually a company. So when you say Epson salt, Epson is the company. It's not the kind of salt. The salt is magnesium. But Epson, who's been running things since the colonial days, is actually sending across, from my understanding, very cheap, low quality byproduct magnesium. And that still even does something. But when you get into parental grade, which is basically professional grade magnesium, and you soak the body in it, and we have pure crystals, no scents, none of that, you soak your body in these crystals, then it begins to rapidly repair the system, because the system needs the magnesium. So that's one line of defense, is basically getting this in someone's, letting a person end up healing their body and their ailments and their broken areas and their clogged, they got clogged ligaments and all these kind of things, to get this cream on them. So that way the magnesium can start getting in there and breaking down the minerals, breaking up all the different stagnancies within the system. Another one of the products, which everyone is pretty much familiar with, is the Complete Internal Cleansing Kit. And While the Clean and Kernel Cleansing Kit is one of the best presentations as far as a person needing something that is a step-by-step process to get them cleansed, I find the most effective part of the cleansing kits, that's the colon and the internal cleansing, or complete internal cleansing, is actually the commitment. Because once you get a person to commit to cleaning themselves, like either way, they're gonna feel different. I mean, if you go into a process, if you're not eating all that junk for 6 days, and you're not necessarily starving as you go through this process, but you know, there's some times where your cravings and urges and your worms and your candida want that sugar. So all day, when they go through that and they start mind over matter, and that's why they need you there, because if you say, hey, you know, you're gonna take this cleanse, oh yeah, I'm gonna take it, and then you know, they get the cleanse, you call up, hey, you're on it now? Yeah, I'm gonna start on Friday. Okay, either I'll do it with you or I'm gonna check on you. I'll connect with you and see how you're doing it. Third day, hey, what's going on? Man, I'm on day 3. You wouldn't believe what just came out. So when you get into that whole process with the person, that motivates them to continue to finish it, because we're communal beings. Okay, so we power each other in a positive, in a harmonic way. And part of that process is when someone is assisting us with getting through something that may be tough. Like if you go, it's a dark cave right there, trying to walk in by yourself. I don't know, maybe I'm turning around. 3-4 friends, let's go into this cave. You see, so that's how it works. So this is the part of that process, is getting them to commit to going through the cleansing for themselves, and then they experience those withdrawals and things like that, but they start to fight back, is what you really see. They start to fight against their urges that have developed within their system that more than likely are related to things that are gonna cause them harm. And then once they do it, then that next part of the human psyche kicks in, like, shoot, if I just wash this thing, the last thing I want to do is get it dirty. So next time someone tries to slide a pizza in their way, they're like, they start thinking about those days of the cleansing, and then they're like, maybe, you know, no, I don't eat that kind of stuff anymore. And it always feels good to say that. It's like a person who becomes a vegetarian for a while, it's just saying, hey, I'm a vegetarian. And the response that you get from people, they think you'd have told them you're the Christ or something. It's like, vegetarian? So it's the same thing when you say, oh, I don't eat that anymore, I don't do that anymore. People like, it makes them feel like you've achieved some higher level of power because that's what's actually happened. So as you see here, there's actually a couple more things. There's a colon cleansing kit. And just very briefly, so you understand, the complete internal cleansing kit has a certain price point that a lot of people or some people don't feel comfortable with unless they're fully dedicated. But if you can get the person at least to do a colon cleansing kit, because that's going to remove the primary problem. Let's think about what happens here. When the person's eating all of this stuff, right? Let me check my batteries on the microphone. Like nowadays, everything that you say after one of these conversations, you have to put a disclaimer. I'm not talking about like the batteries, like I'm on binary that I take batteries. But no, it's it's the microphone. So just to understand the colon cleansing kit, because when we talk about what happens here, what gets damaged the most within the body? Of course, the colon, because the colon's got to process all this stuff. The intestines, of course, they get bogged down. And they're tied into the chakra that needs to base, is the chakra that is basically like your guardian. The root chakra in the body is chief in attempts to powering up all the other parts of the chakra center. It's basically the strong fire generating frequency, right? That call comes from the root chakra. So if the intestines are clogged and the colon is clogged, it can't vibrate. The mucoid plaque forms the film around it. That's basically the husk. So when you move that out or you clear that out, then the body can start to vibrate, and that actually brings more of the system of awareness online. So we need to be really specific here about what we're talking about and what this stuff does. This is not just about, hey, go buy this. No, this is about, once you do this, you can expect these results, because this is how it works. This stuff is very specific to how it works. So obviously getting rid of, you know, some people still got Similac with iron. For anyone who knows what Similac is, that's like the genetically modified baby foods that they give babies. There's Similac, there's Enfamil. Some people still actually have deposits of Similac and Enfamil in their intestines. If the rule of thumb here is if you've never cleaned it, it's still there. Margarine, especially. Margarine is another. It turns into a hard plastic type of substance, and then it just sits there on the walls. And then the more the walls build up, it's like a tube. The less space is in the center of the tube. And this, again, causes obesity. It causes back ups in the body, so there's toxicity. I mean, once the body starts to back up, it's like a sewer system. Once it backs up, it's going to eventually start coming out of the top. It's going to come out of the top of the toilet. So what happens with that on the symbolic level with this is when the body is too toxic, the mind becomes toxic. All thoughts become toxic. The consciousness becomes toxic, etc. So going on, there's also a parasite cleansing kit here that deals specifically with parasites. Mainly that candida. That candida is a monster because it looks for the host, and it just sets up shop, and it tries to make sure that the only bacteria around or anything around is candida. And then once that happens, candida has a certain frequency that's like having a mind of its own. So in intense, the urges for a donut, the urges for some white sugar, the urges for some flour, the urges for many different things come from the candida and many of the parasites in the body. This, don't think that's you. That's the parasite looking to sustain itself. It's trying to live and protect its life. So it needs you to go and eat something that actually is going to kill you. So this is a serious thing. And that's what these kits and products do, is they get rid of, they change your system. It's an ultimatum, basically. It's like terrain modification. Your system changes and back into its harmonic field, and whatever doesn't vibrate with that properly, then is discarded. The next thing is, obviously, Patrick Flanagan's Mega Hydrate, which I did a deep study on myself. I took some ORP meters, took some pH meters, and I actually did the test on how effective is hydrogen in the body. And I found out, well, hydrogen, silica, and a few more things that are added into this formula, I found out that it was very effective at becoming even an energetic source for the body. So it's basically like what they call the oxycutum. Let's oxycutum, meaning when you pump the body with oxygen and hydrogen, it's like hydrogen peroxide in the sense to how it creates the bubbles and it starts to get rid of the infections. It starts to clear up the blood. That's where they had live blood analysis of people who have taken Mega Hydrate, and then we see their blood, and you see, begin to see that the blood begins to clear itself up, and the bacteria that are in the blood begin to be consumed by the white blood cells who now have the energetic potential to do so. So that's what Mega Hydrate is really about, and it does its thing. The next thing that we have down here is the alkalizer. Alkalizer is like break glass in case of emergency. Let me check really briefly here to make sure everybody is connected properly. Okay, there we go. We're still in good condition. So alkalizer, break glass in case of emergency. This is the person who, you know, you have to look at that. One of the main things preventing people from making the change in their life is accessibility. Accessibility. Accessibility could be how available is it for me, how fast can I get it into my system, and how much does it cost? So that's the more the primary interest with the person, especially when they're in the beginning phases. And what alkalizer does is it's like custom for that person who is still straddling the fence, meaning that they're still toxifying their body in a sense to how much acid they're putting in their body, but you know they're trying to make it happen. And like I said, terrain modification means that you don't try to do all this at one time and quit cold turkey, literally. That's like always one of my funny statements. Maybe it's only funny to me, but some people have to go through the process. So there's a lot of guilt that happens when they eat something that's very greasy and, you know, they start feeling tired and they're like, man, you know, now it's got to go through my whole system because they've already been explained that. And what alkalizer does is alkalizes the proprietary formula that immediately takes the body's pH from an acid range back into an alkalinity range, thus allowing it to speedily remove that whatever acid was put into the body from the body by giving it the stomach the ability to process it. Because, you know, the stomach has what we would say is an acid, which is really more of like, you know, using the same term to explain two different things, but it's more of like an acid that begins to break down things, okay? So when you have an alkaline and an acid, then you get the pH level. That's what pH level is. It's the alkaline or the acidic level. So if something is too far into the acidic stage, then what happens in your stomach is that acid is not able to break down what you just put into your system. That acid needs to be brought back up closer to the alkalinity range. And that's what alkabase does. That's also why alkabase fixes ulcers. Alkabase fixes, you know, some people have this problem when they get up in the morning, their stomach's burning. And if they put something on it like orange juice, it's like they just threw lighter fluid in there. And it's because now it's way too much acid. Orange juice is very acidic. So this develops sores in the stomach. And these sores are synonymous with, also if a person's not actually feeling anything physically, it's when they have that bad attitude in the morning, or they get what's either called a hungry headache, or they're angry because they're hungry. Okay, this is the acid, and this neutralizes that. And it does it in a very short period of time. I've seen people make complete turnarounds in 3 days from having ulcer-type symptoms in their stomach and the burning and the anger and all that. So that's what alkabase is, which is the alkalizer. So moving on, what we also have is we have the blood purifier. And what the blood purifier is about 60 Ayurvedic remedies, all plants, that clean the blood. And generally anyone, this is like, I guess if you could call it a cheap version of internal cleansing, because there's also evacuation that takes place when a person drinks this, meaning that a lot of the impurities in their system come out the other side. This thing is like a squeegee when it comes to beginning to remove things from the body from the top down. So from the time you drink it, it moves through the system and it begins to drag all of the, you know, real nastiness out of the body, and then allows you to evacuate it. And then it works directly with the blood in order to get the blood clear from parasites. So that's the blood purifier. And again, you can go into any of these products and you can read in more in depth about them. The last ones here, actually these need to be removed. Toxin absorber and friendly bacteria replenisher are being removed because they're actually no longer carried by the supplier, and we're gonna find some replacements for that. You have the digestive stimulator, which are actually what calls you, I'm sure you like my term, to evacuate. This means go use the restroom. It causes you to evacuate. So anyone who's actually has constipation or they have problems even during the cleanse to, you know, moving out the toxins from their system, then the bacteria replenisher is what they take in order to assist them in removing those bacteria from the system. And then the last thing you see here, of course, is the cell salt. Not the cell salts, but the high grade magnesium crystals, which I spoke about earlier. So let me go here very briefly. All right. So that's it for today. I'm not sure exactly how long that took us. I think we're probably at the 2 hour mark. Let me see, is it 12 yet? Oh wow, 2.5 hours. Okay, well I thought that would take a little bit less time. So I'm gonna go ahead and conclude today's message and meeting and let everyone just digest. Even to say digest sounds a little funny right now. Let everyone digest what was presented, And oh wow, look at what we got here. All right, this is baby Ara. This is my daughter. And she was just in the kitchen preparing something with mommy. So I just want to say wholeness and balance vibrations to everyone. And I want to thank you for tuning in today and to this amazing message. I mean, again, it's a little bit hard. Smells good. A little bit hard to transmit in the tense to the bulk of the information. But I believe that you get the gist of what I'm saying about the difference between the binary and that state of consciousness versus the wholeness and where you are as a human being. So again, if you need to reach us, you could do so by email. And if there's any questions that you have, you can do so in Teamwork, which everyone here has access to Teamwork. If you want to let other friends know about Spiritek, they can go to spiritek.com. The link is also in the description. And we will be reconvening, not this Sunday coming up, but the next Sunday. And we'll get into another aspect of the products and the categories of products so that everyone that's participating can learn more. So wholeness and balance vibration, and we'll talk to you soon. Say goodbye. Say bye-bye.
Bye-bye. What's that, Daddy?
It's the show, ma'am. What?
It's the show.
Yeah.
That's you, show.
Yeah.
That's you, Papa.
Yeah. One second.
One second.
All right, let me.